So how do I know if I'm cured of prostate cancer once I receive treatment? And what's a good PSA level after treatment? Well, if you've had a radical prostatectomy, your PSA should be undetectable in order to deem yourself cured of the cancer. And that's sort of the beauty of having surgery, and that if you do not have any prostate tissue remaining in your body, your PSA level should be undetectable. If it is undetectable, then you are cured. So that's why we follow patients after having radical prostatectomy with frequent PSAs, often in the first year. We will do it every 3 to 6 months. And then after 2 years, we'll check it annually. It should be checked at least up to 10 years because there are cases where it can recur up to 8 to 10 or even 12 years after you've had a prostatectomy. So it's important that you have it checked annually, and earlier after surgery, get it checked more frequently. If there is detectable PSA following a prostatectomy, that likely means you have recurrent cancer, and those treatment options you should discuss with your urologist on how to deal with it at that point. You will need scans such as CAT scans and bone scans in order to try to detect where the cancer is, but this can often be difficult to do. Following radiation, it's a little trickier because prostate has not been removed, so you don't usually get an undetectable PSA. The current guidelines used by the radiation oncologists is having a PSA of under 1 is considered a cure. The difficulty becomes in subsequent years after having undergone radiation, if your PSA starts rising, say from 0.6 to 0.8 to 1 to 1.2, and at that time, if it's rising rapid enough, we will recommend you undergo a prostate biopsy to determine if there is any residual cancer within the prostate. So the answer is, if you've had a radical prostatectomy, your PSA should be undetectable. And if you've had radiation, whether that's brachytherapy or seed implant or external beam radiation therapy, your PSA should be below 1.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.